Good morning, everyone. It's Tuesday, and what a great day for us to dig into the Word of God together, is it not? Although, is there ever a bad day for that? No. So I hope you join us every day. I really do. Hey, these last 2 weeks, we're looking at, for the fun of it, really, the shortest books in the Bible. And we're all the way up to number 4. And the reason, of course, is these books often are overlooked, and no book of the Bible should ever be overlooked. So yesterday was Obadiah, and that was the last Old Testament book on our list. That's a hint for if you're deciding what your guess is for the shortest book in the Bible. Number four is the book of Jude. J-U-D-E. Now, are you familiar with the book of Jude? Can you tell me off the top of your head what it's even about? Probably not. If you can, you get a gold star. You get a gold star for today. And let me know you knew. That'd be fun. I've never heard a sermon on it. I might have heard a verse or two quoted, but it's an important, all books are important. Now, who is Jude? There is a little bit of debate on it, but the vast majority of scholars believe, based that he says he's the brother of James, he's the half-brother of Jesus. You know, Jesus had other brothers, and Judas, was one of them. A fairly common name in that time. But Jude writes with such authority And yet humbleness. He even says in verse 1, Jude, a servant of Jesus Christ and a brother of James. So it's probably out of humility. He now sees his place. Can you imagine that your half brother was God himself take on the form of a man in human flesh? That's a tough brother to live up to, isn't it? And he doesn't try to. He just says a servant of Jesus Christ. So Jude, his book, by the way, is 608 words long. All these that now have only one chapter. Those 608 words are in one chapter. Obadiah had 669, so not a whole lot shorter. Well, how much shorter can we get? Well, you'll find out if you stick with us through the week. Now, why did Jude write this letter? Let's just read a little bit. And, you know, he says himself why he wrote the letter. Verse 3, and he says, "Dear friends, although I was very eager to write to you about the salvation we share," he wanted it to be an uplifting, joyful book, it sounds like to me. He wanted to write about the salvation we share. Let's just rejoice in God and who he is. But then we go on. He says, "I felt I had to write. I was forced. I needed to write and urge you to contend for the faith that was once entrusted to the saints." Why? Verse 4. "For certain men whose condemnation was written about long ago have secretly slipped in among you. They are godless men who changed the grace of our God into license for immorality. And they deny that Jesus Christ is our only sovereign and Lord." There was false teaching even in the first century. Only a couple of decades after Jesus had lived and conquered death and rose from the dead, and the apostles were quickly teaching and spreading the word, but there were other people that were spreading false teaching. And Jude couldn't stand that. False teachers entering the church. What was their false teaching that they were spreading? Well, Gnosticism. You ever heard that word? Gnosticism was one of the very first. You could say cults, we call them that often today, but they were heresies. They were diluting the Christian faith with false teaching, including that Jesus wasn't God. But Gnosticism, actually the word Gnosticism, it means to know in Greek. And so knowledge was their thing, that we're going to seek knowledge. More and more knowledge means more and more wisdom, you could say. But that is just not true. And instead, because it was based on knowledge and so on, they were spreading the thought that you could do anything, which of course leads to immorality. Judas warns, I encourage you to read through the whole book. He warns about these things. He warns that they were exercising sinful license to do anything, that they were rebelling against authority of the apostles in the church or elders in their local church. They were giving into their own desires. They were being concerned only with gain for themselves. And they were fault finding and boasting, and they were very, very divisive in the early church. So if you read through the rest of the book of Jude, you're going to find that he addresses each one of these things in a verse or two. He was very concerned. He loved, obviously, the church, which is what? God's family here on earth. So Jude shared that same love for the church that Jesus did, God does. And so what was his answer ultimately? Well, he wants you to, well, he wanted them to kick them out of the church. And how would they know false teaching? This will be our verse for today. In verse 17, he says, but dear friends, so he had already told all the things they were doing, but dear friends, remember what the apostles of our Lord Jesus Christ foretold. And then he goes on, they said to you, in the past times there will be scoffers who follow their own godly desires, and these are they. So in that first century, Gnostics were the problem, or the heresy that he was addressing. But the generalization for us all, and that's partly why in the last previous 2 weeks, we went through the various religions and belief systems. Why? Because only Christians and Jesus have the truth. Jesus said, I am the truth. So that set him apart. But verse 17, remember what the apostles taught, basically. Now, how can you remember something that you don't know? You can't. So in essence, Jude is saying, you have to know your Bible. You have to know what the Bible says. You have to know what the apostles and the whole Bible have taught. So friends, we need to read our Bibles. We need to study. You got to take advantage of the things that are open to you. In just about two Saturdays from now, we teach our next sessions of our foundations class, the foundations of the faith. Do you know what all those are? I just encourage, don't pass up opportunities to learn more about the Word of God. That's what I get out of the book of Jude. I hope it's meaningful to you. I hope we'll remember. Man, in a way, these short books, because they're so condensed, they teach us truth quickly. Ah, I'm really being blessed by them, and I hope that you are also. Well, tomorrow we get down to the third shortest. God bless. Walk closely with your Lord today.